This is Riemann's zeta function, and it is equal to infinity in the critical strip. Riemann proved an amazing one-to-one correspondence between this famous sum and this function. He showed that many infinite values of the zeta function corresponding to finite number in the critical strip. In some sense, like an origami boat that we can unfold and refold to a bird. This one-to-one corresponding process is commonly known as analytic continuation. Since then, many other functions with similar properties have been invented. The transcendental zeta function is the most recent zeta function. You can see the proof for this zeta function in the Riemann's last theorem article. This is a similar zeta function that we can obtain from the Riemann's zeta function. You can see the proof for this function in the Riemann's last theorem article as well. B equal to 1 gives us Riemann's zeta function, and B equal to infinity gives us the transcendental zeta function. This means that we can put Riemann's zeta function and ABC's zeta function in a one-to-one correspondence in the critical strip. In the next few minutes, we will see how to generate the last key that we need to prove that the Riemann hypothesis is correct. Please pay close attention to the term 1 over n to the power s in these specific zeta functions. For clarity, let's show Riemann's zeta function as zeta s sub r and call it zeta r. Notice the location of 1 over n to the power s in this zeta function. Considering that, we can write the transcendental zeta function in such a way that becomes the difference of the zeta r minus a simple function with one term in the critical strip. Here it is. This is the last key that we will need for proving the Riemann hypothesis. In the next video, you will see how to apply the last key to this property of the zeta function to unlock a century and a half problem in less than 10 minutes. Otherwise, you will get a $10,000 reward. Please like and subscribe, and thank you very much for watching. Have a great time.